Sri Hissey Lachungpa.
The Citizenship Amendment Bill is before us for debate and passing. We in Sikkim, sir, have many apprehensions as the whole concept of citizenship, Indian citizenship, was granted to the Sikkim subject holders in 1975. When we became the 22nd state of the Indian Union. This, the Sikkim subject, is therefore as sacrosanct identity of those who were the citizens of Sikkim under the erstwhile Chogyal. Today, we are deliberating on a bill that has many ramifications nationally as well as locally in the Northeast region and within Sikkim, which is also a part of the Northeast. Sir, from Sikkim point of view, we are opposed to this bill from the standpoint of its potential dilution of the Article 371F. This captures the essence of the provisions under which the Sikkim Kingdom was merged with the Indian Union in 1975 after a referendum. All that the people of Sikkim know is the Sikkim subject register, and under this we stand protected. That the Honorable Minister has assured that all 371 provisos will not be diluted by the CAB is certainly welcomed. This, however, must be in both letter and spirit. The CAB bill is in present form will go against the very nature of the spirit of 371F. The rest of the Northeast states have been exempted either by means of the inner line permit system or as the six scheduled areas. Whilst Sikkim stands unprotected by either of these two exemptions given. In Sikkim, we have both RAP and ILP for foreigners, and hence no foreigners can come and seek a citizenship without setting foot in Sikkim. To that extent, we are protected. I appeal to the Honorable Home Minister to extend the ILP under the Bengal Act to Sikkim as well, since it is also being extended to the state of Manipur. It should also not be difficult, as we already have a framework in place, as already stated by me. In this regard, I seek the assurance of the Honorable Home Minister on the floor of this House and during the reply. Thank you, Jai Hind.
Thank you so much.